File Explorer now includes tabs. There's a video editor built directly into Windows 11. Snap layouts are now easier than ever to use. These are just a few of the new updates that Microsoft is releasing today for Windows 11. Let's check out all of these new updates. The first big update, File Explorer now has tabs. As a quick aside, to launch File Explorer, press the Windows key together with the E key, E as in Explorer. Within File Explorer, you can now navigate to different locations and have a tab open for each one of those locations. It's just like in your browser window. Now, you no longer have to open up separate windows of File Explorer. Also, the homepage of File Explorer has been newly redesigned. Up on top, you have quick access, and this is where you can pin or favorite different folders. Simply right-click on a folder and you can add it to quick access. Down below, you have a section called favorites, and this is where you could favorite or pin a document that you go back to often. Simply right-click on a document and here you can add it to favorites. Down below, there's a section called Recents, and this shows you all of the documents that you've worked on recently. Update number two, you now have more options to customize what your start menu looks like. Currently, you have three rows of pinned apps, and then you have three rows of recommendations, but you can now personalize what that looks like. Within settings, you can choose to have more pinned apps, or you could choose to keep the default or the even view, or here you can show more recommendations. Down below, you can also toggle on or off various settings. Update 3, Snap layouts are now easier to use. When you select a window, you'll see this black bar appear at the top of the screen. If you go up and hover over that, it'll show you all of the different snap layout positions, and you can now snap your window to any one of these positions. Now, personally, I prefer using shortcut keys. You can also select a window and then press the Windows key together with the arrow keys, and then you could snap your window to different areas of your screen. Update 4, the taskbar now includes an overflow menu. In the past, when you had a lot of apps open, well, the overflow items would just fall into the abyss. But now you can click on this menu and you can get back to any one of your apps. Next update, there's now a fully functional video editor built directly into Windows 11 called ClipChamp. Simply go down to your start menu and search for ClipChamp, and then you can launch it. One of my favorite features, you can record your screen and your webcam at the same time. So you now have a screen recorder built directly into Windows. The video editor itself is very good, and you can pull together some very impressive looking videos. For a full walkthrough of how you can use ClipChamp, check out the video right up above. The next feature is called Studio Effects. And with this, I can make sure that I am always kept in the frame, even if I happen to be moving around. There's also something called eye contact, so my eyes will continue looking at the camera even if I happen to be looking somewhere else. I can also apply a slight background blur behind me. These settings are also available outside of Microsoft Teams. Next update, you can use focus sessions in the clock app. Here, you can choose how much time you want to focus for. So I'll choose some time. Down below, you can also choose the task that you want to focus on. Once you start focus sessions, it'll turn on Do Not Disturb mode. This will silence all notifications and it'll also turn off badges on your taskbar. It can also remind you to take breaks while you're focusing. There have also been a number of improvements to accessibility. Here, when I click on accessibility in the bottom right-hand corner, here I can enable narration. When I turn this on, there are now new voices available which sound more natural. Let's take a listen.
I am a high-quality speech voice.
That sounds pretty natural. There's also another feature called live captions, and this will generate captions for any audio that's playing on your computer. Next update, there's something called smart app control. If you attempt to install a potentially malicious app, Microsoft will flag that to you. This will help you stay safer. The one downside is that you have to reinstall Windows to be able to start taking advantage of this. Update number 10, you can now install Android apps natively on Windows regardless of where you are in the world. Previously, this was limited to the United States. You now have access to over 20,000 apps. To learn how to start using this, check out the video right up above. And this brings us to update number 11. Widgets now appear on your taskbar in the bottom left-hand corner. When you click on it, you'll now also see local and current events included. And you could also react and also comment on different articles. To get the latest 2022 update, go into Windows Settings. In the bottom left-hand corner, click on Windows Update, and then you can download all of these latest updates. All right, well, that's the new 2022 update. If you want to see a full comprehensive list of everything that's new, I've included a blog post down below in the description. Also, I've been playing around with these new features for quite some time now. If you want to be able to use these types of features before the general public, you can join what's called the Windows Insider Program, and that way you can be a beta tester and you can see things that are coming up in the pipeline before the general public. So what do you think about all of these updates? Does it have everything that you wanted, or are some things still missing? I know one thing that's missing for me, I want to be able to drag and drop files from, let's say, File Explorer onto an app on my taskbar. Maybe that's coming soon. Hopefully, Microsoft. To watch more videos like this one, please consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.